It's time to present your wireframe to all stakeholders. Now make sure you do this in one meeting with everybody together as a group. If you present to one stakeholder at a time, you're going to find yourself pulled in too many opposing directions. By presenting and discussing as a group, it will encourage a collaborative process while also keeping the conversation productive. When one stakeholder has a louder voice than others, which is inevitable if you talk to each person individually, tunnel vision is likely to set in and derail the entire project. Trust me, it happens all the time. Once you have all of your stakeholders together, walk them through each visual decision in detail and explain the methods to your madness. Explain why you chose the illustration style and icon styles that you did, why you plan to use the fonts that you're using, and why you plan to use the colors and how. Walk them through the infographic from top to bottom, discussing each illustration and icon to ensure that the approach sounds right to everybody. Sometimes better ideas will arise. Other times you'll learn that certain imagery is not preferred by the client. But most of the time, you'll find that your stakeholders are getting more and more excited as you go. When you confidently walk stakeholders through each design decision, they're going to feel more informed and in control of the process. The only way to meet expectations is to first set and define them, after all, and the wireframe provides the best opportunity to do exactly that. Now, be sure to ask your stakeholders clear questions that engender more than a yes or no answer. For example, when you look at this wireframe, what immediate elements stand out to you? Listen closely to their answers. Did the elements that you intended to stand out resonate with your stakeholders, or did they get lost in the shuffle? Or say, I suggest that we go with an illustration style that represents a 90s motif. This is because the 90s were such an integral part of the evolution of e-commerce, and I want to represent that to our audience. Do you agree with this approach, or is there something else you would like me to consider? By first stating why you did something before asking a question, you set your stakeholders up to review the wireframe with a critical eye driven by the 5 W's instead of just considering their own personal likes and dislikes. If a stakeholder is remaining silent, make sure that they have a chance to weigh in as well. Call on them specifically, noting that they haven't weighed in yet and you would value their opinion. Often, it's the silent stakeholders that either have great ideas or are already sold by your ideas. In either situation, you win because they're going to benefit the group with their great ideas or further solidify your creative approach by backing up your choices. Now, if you skip this step and you simply send stakeholders a wireframe to review and compile their own feedback, you're giving up your power as a designer. This is because you are asking them to make sense of everything without any context behind why you made the decisions that you did. In a sense, you're asking them to become art directors by simply responding to a very low-poly layout without anyone there to champion the creative vision. But by explaining the why behind each design decision, your stakeholders will trust you even more. They'll have a better vision for the first design draft and likely request very few edits once they receive it.